God is at work in you. This you have to be aware. You are here not by yourself and not by yourself. You are here by God and for God. The more, the earlier you realize this truth, your life is going to flourish. If you don't realize it, you will struggle with your life, with your problem, and you will never reach anywhere. We are created by God and for God. And He is at work in us. We are created by God. Second, God is at work in you. When God is at work in you, you can be confident and move in life. When all the things are closed, third, God will give the break. God will do His work and will just turn. You will be thinking it is an end, it will become a turn. It will become a bend, and that is God's trend. Praise the Lord. So God will do which you never imagine, as we read in 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 9 onwards. What no eye has seen, what no ear has heard, what no one imagined, God will do for us. Not only He will break that atmosphere and give a new hope, new life to us, but also He will prepare a new ground. From there you can move on in life. He will prepare a platform for you. In today's gospel, we find the same thing. The people are, suddenly Jesus sees a lot of people are coming. How is it possible? The Bible says it's a lonely place. And it is going to be Feast of Paschal. And everybody is supposed to go to Jerusalem and to their relatives. When God is using you, God will provide you. What no eye can see or what no mind can understand, God will be at work in you. Jesus is in a lonely place and thousands of people are flocking. It's God's work. He will bring river in the desert. Believe in your Lord. If you don't believe in the Lord, how can you expect your Lord to do mighty things? If you don't believe your God is a mighty God, how do you expect mighty things in your life? You want mighty things, but you think your God is a helpless. You are a helpless being. If your God is a mighty God, and if you are His child, believe you are a mighty person. If you think of yourself small, how can God do great things through you? You can be only what you think of be. You can be only what you preach to be. Yes, our God is a mighty God. And we find here, He asks Philip, how are we going to feed them? He is asking how we are going to make them to have the food. Immediately, Philip only thinks about the problem. Oh, where will we get bread for them? Will not. There's a beautiful song we have in Sangamam song in Telugu. Naru posina devudu neeru poyaka manuna. Will not God, who planted the tree, will also arrange the tree to be poured, the water to be poured? Will He not, who planted, take care of the tree? Yes, that's what is spoken in the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 3, verse 6. It is not the one who planted and not the one even who watered. It is the Lord who makes the plant to grow. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And now, when Jesus said about how are we going to feed, Philip is worried about the problem. And Andrew is talking about incapability. How are we going to do? But through Andrew, the incapable man, God is bringing a break. Andrew says, I'm seeing a boy who is having 5 bread and 2 fishes. The love of the boy's mother. even before he gets up and come, because each bread, as we know, is solid bread. How can a mother for a little boy can give 5 loaves and 2 solid fishes? It's God's intention, God's plan. God might have woke up. Maybe I think his mother might have been busy making. Maybe my son will be hungry. Maybe how many days? Maybe it is God woke her up and made 5 bread and 2 fishes, tasty fishes, and sent to the son. My dear friends, when the Lord was looking chance, where is the break? When problem comes, you wait on the Lord, and the Lord will give you the break, because he is at work in you. God, you are created by him and for him, and God is at work in you. Second, third, because he is at work in you, amidst the problem, God will break it. God will bring the sign. God will do the needful. God will do the turning. When you walk with him, which is beyond our thinking, that's what in Psalm 118 it is said, the stone that is rejected by all will become the cornerstone. That is the mighty work of God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Immediately, Jesus was looking for a break from where the Father is going to do something needful. Where is the bend starting? It is not the end, it is the bend. And then Andrew says, here is a boy. Jesus says, come on, come on, make everybody sit. Because he knew the Father. The Father doesn't give us life without problem. But the Father gives us life which is full of problem, but with full of blessings, with full of breakthroughs. Your God is a God who gives breakthrough. If you walk with him, if you keep your mind on him, that's why in Isaiah 26 verse 3 says, he keeps in perfect peace whose mind is fixed on the Lord. You have to be fixed. And Jesus' mind is fixed on the Father. He didn't bother, so many thousands, how am I going to know? He did not take Philip's advice or Andrew's disappointments. He took them all as advantage. Took the bread, took it, and looked up. Many of the times, what you have may not be sufficient to your mind, but it is more than enough for your God. So what you need to do? You have to lift it to God. Your problems, lift it to God. Your disappointments, don't allow your disappointment to disappoint you and make everybody who are with you to disappoint. Jesus took the bread and lifted up to the Father. Daddy, I surrender to you. The moment he lifted it up to the Father, it's now his duty. He's beginning. When you come to an end, your God begins. Yes. And the Father blessed that bread. He thanked, Jesus thanked, before even the miracle happens. Yes, that is called faith. Faith means 2 things. As we read in Hebrews 11:6, faith means believe our God is a living God. Faith means, second, he always does for those who trust in him. And as Jesus thanked the Father did what Jesus thanked for. What for which you are thanking, which the Father will do in your life. And 5,000 people are fully fed. And Jesus says, when God does the miracles, always gather the rest, the left out, and use it for the future. Whenever God does miracles, kindly convey that and continue to proclaim, be a witness, that it will be helpful for the future generation also.